Hi, 94.7 Highveld Stereo.
Hi.
You've reached the automated response line. Please say which division you'd like to go to.
Competition
say
entry.
Say it now.
Competition entry.
Say it now.
Competition entry.
Listen, I said say it now.
Competition entry.
We have it recorded as competition entry. Is this correct?
Yes.
Please answer yes or no.
Yes.
Congratulations. You have won nothing. Okay. Highveld, hello?
You've played a song that you've played, yeah, you played it twice for the day. You played it this morning and you played it now at 2:48, and the song is Jody.
Okay, wait, you can just hold on.
Okay, thank you.
I'm just going to speak to Pabi now.
Okay,
Okay, I'm just going to put you on hold, so it's going to go silent. It might sound like the call's dropped, but it hasn't dropped, okay?
Okay, thank you, I'll hold.
Pubby, yes, I got this guy on the line. He's saying that you repeated the Jody Williams song. Yeah, I know. I know, I can't handle this anymore, Pubby. These stupid people, they're phoning and bugging me all the time on this line. I know, how stupid you got to be. It wasn't repeated. I know. Okay, I'll just be nice and I'll just say, thank you for calling. Huh?
Yeah.
No, it wasn't the repeat.
Okay. Lady told me now. She says she heard it after 9 and then she heard it now again at 2:48.
Nah, well, she's lying to you.
She's lying to me.
I just can't anymore.
Now, that guy's boss calls me back.
Oh, beautiful.
Highveld, how may I be of your service?
Hi, good day. I'm speaking to?
To Peter.
Peter, my name is Magret.
Magret. I'm sorry. I'm sorry about that.
I want you to broadcast my voice on Highveld.
Yes?
By the language that you just used when one of my employees phoned you.
What did I say?
You said, he told us you said the people that's phoning in. He's so shocked because of your language.
Who?
And he's sending an email around to everyone now telling that your language are shocking on our South Syria.
Are you his mother?
No, I'm not his mother. I'm his supervisor. We are phoning from a very big company.
I'm just wondering why he's getting you to fight his battles.
He's not getting me to fight his battles.
Then what are you doing then?
Well, sir, I want to broadcast it to the world. What is your language?
Okay, well, we don't broadcast to the world, ma'am, so you might want to phone up the BBC World Service.
That is shocking.
I think he's a liar.
You think he's a liar?
Yes, because I've been answering this phone and I never said such a nasty word.
How can you just tell he's a liar? We're all sitting here in the office, sir.
Yeah, but you didn't hear what I said.
I'm working for a lawyer's company and I know my rights.
Ooh, don't think and you scare me.
I promise you, sir, and I think what you just did, speak to Ferdy now, was wrong.
Is it Ferdy?
His name is Ferdinand.
Do you pack his lunch as well?
His lunch as well, and I also sleep with him, sir.
Okay, you know what?
Okay, so enjoy your day.
No, it's Whackhead. It's Whackhead. It's Whackhead. Hold on. You
just frightened.
Yes, Whackhead, I'll put it with you.
Yes, veneer. Dude, and you lied, bro.
Whackhead.
Yes. I never swore once.
No, but the person... Okay, yes.
Oh! No, but the person... Okay, yes.
Yeah. Don't quote me, I'm recording.
Highveld, how may I be of service?
Good afternoon. I just want to query the tickets for Celine Dion. I just wanted to know if you were able to help me with the amounts of the tickets.
It is 13,000 rand.
You mean for one ticket?
For one ticket, yeah.
Is that the price for all the tickets?
No, that's for one ticket standing at the back.
At the back?
Standing. Looking through the window of the Coca-Cola Dome.
Is it?
Yeah. If you want a ticket, do you want a ticket inside?
Obviously.
35,000.
All right, who am I speaking to?
Piet.
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 All right, well, thank you so much for that.
Okay, okay, bye-bye.
Bye.
I felt alone.
Can you tell me, have you mentioned this keyword yet? But I just thought maybe I missed it because I'm working at the police. I'm on the switchboard.
Okay, I tell you what.
If I give Who am I speaking to?
Piet.
Yes.
If I give you the keyword,
yeah,
then can you squash a charge against me?
What is it?
Housebreaking.
Housebreaking, no, Darren. Thank you.
Okay, bye.
Dad, bye.
Highveld, hello.
Hello.
Hi, how are you?
Fine, and you?
Good, what are you wearing?
Who's speaking?
It's Piet.
Sorry, I think it's the wrong number.
What number are you looking for? Hi.
How are you doing?
Hi, how are you?
I'm well, thank you. Is this 94.7?
What you doing?
I was calling for 94.7 for the mystery or maestro.
Is it?
Yeah.
You sound quite nice.
May I speak to Kenny, please? Or the producer?
I'm the producer.
I'm not too comfortable talking to you.
Why is that?
You sound weird.
Where do you like hang out?
No, I think I'm going to cut this call now. Thank you.
I like the way you sound.
Thank you very much.
I think you sound hot. You sound hot. Heartfelt, how may I be of service?
Hi, the time travel, is it finished?
Ma'am, I'm not sure. You've come through to the wrong department. You're currently in the workshop.
Oh, shoot. Okay, what is the right number? Sorry.
Hold on, I can put you through to the studio.
Okay, thanks. I'm sorry about that, yeah.
Okay, hold on. I felt hello.
Hi, time travel?
Oh, they put you through to the wrong department, ma'am.
Okay, this can you give me the right number, perhaps?
This is the kitchen. I'll transfer you to the studio now. Hold on, sorry about this. Hold on. I felt hello, this is the lounge.
No, come on. Okay, never mind.
What department are you looking for, ma'am?
I'm looking for the time travel. Look, I'm...
Oh, that would be the studio. Hold on one sec, ma'am, I'll put you through now. Hi, you're through to the toilet. How can I help you?
Never mind, I've definitely got the wrong answer. And who am I speaking to now?
Piet.
Piet, you're bloody naughty, but thanks anyway.
I felt hello.
Yeah, hi there, how are you?
I'm fine and you, thank you so much for asking.
No, not a problem.
How are you?
No, not too bad, man.
I'm fine, thanks, and you?
Not too bad.
Yeah, good, I'm great, thanks, and you?
No, I'm cool.
Okay, bye-bye. Bye. Highveld, how may I help you?
I would like Highveld to play a song for my husband, please.
Okay, so here we go. Start with your dedication, ma'am.
Okay, I would just like to say to Michael, he's my best friend. He's been a wonderful husband. I love him to bits. I don't think he realized how much I love him. And I would just really like to play the song to him. Just to tell him how much I do love him before it's too late.
Okay, and here is the special song.
It's not over.
You're listening to Joburg's number one hit music station. This is 94.7 Highveld Stereo.
Thank you for calling 94.7. All our operators are currently busy. If you know the extension you require, please dial it now. If you don't know the extension, please say it out loud. For instance, please say information.
Information?
Please don't repeat the department that I just said. Come up with your own department.
Okay, reception.
You said Michael Bolton. Is this correct?
No.
Which section would you like to go to? Please speak loudly and clearly.
Reception.
I'm sorry. It seems like your cell phone has got very bad reception. Please say which department you would like to go to.
Reception.
You said Michael Bolton. Is this correct?
No.
You are through to the Michael Bolton fan club on the 94.7 Highveld Stereo website. Would you like to leave a message for Michael Bolton?
No.
Well, that's just being nasty, man. Which department would you like to go to? Hello?
Hello?
Ah, how may I help you?
Hi, is that 94.7?
That is correct, ma'am.
Tell me, the Nixon Honors, are they still at the East End Value Mall?
Where are you right now?
I'm at the East End Value Mall, but I can't see them.
There's your question answered.
Sorry?
I think you just answered your question.
Are they actually marked, or...?
Yeah, there are a few dents and stuff that, you know, those guys are bad drivers.
You don't have to be sarcastic, please, okay?
What are you talking about?
Yes,
what are you... Highveld, how may I be of your service?
Hello?
Hi.
Hi, start 94.7.
That is correct.
I just wondered, you were running an advert about a week ago for legal aid firm that, a lawyer that works through legal aid.
Sorry, ma'am. Could you speak English, please?
Obviously got the wrong number.
No, hold on, it's Highveld. Highveld, hello?
Hello?
Yeah.
This is Mrs. Green speaking. You know, I just played Lady Gaga's Poker Face on the radio, and it played this morning before, just after 8.
Yes.
They've got a policy on the radio that they don't repeat songs, am I right?
Yes, I have heard of it, yes.
They just played Lady Gaga's Poker Face right now, about 2 songs ago. And it played this morning just after 9, so that means it's a repeat. Isn't it?
No.
Well, what is your policy between what and what hours?
It's between 1 and 2 in the afternoon.
Well, I beg to differ because, I mean, I've heard it a lot on the radio. I just want to see what they say on the net, yeah.
What, the Lady Gaga song?
Yes.
Yeah, I have heard it a lot.
No, but they played it this morning and they're playing it now again.
No, they
Didn't
changed...
Just say, no repeat worked out. I just want to see what they say, yeah?
No, you see, they changed that.
No repeat workday? Let me just have a look, yeah?
Are you on the internet now?
I'm on the internet now. I'm just having a look quickly.
Okay, can you do me a favor? Can you... I'll tell you...
It says we want to give you an even wider range of music, so we guarantee not to play the same song twice between 9 a.m. and 5 p.m. Monday to Friday.
Okay, can you do me a favor?
Yes.
Can you just type in this address for me, please? I'll spell it out for you.
Yes?
Are you typing? Okay, www.
Just go to the top. Just hold on for me. Can I go into? Can I tell you the address? www.
Dot.
Yes.
A-S-A-I-N.
A-S-A-I-N.
B-A.
B-A.
B-E.
B-E.
S.
Yeah.
Dot com. S for sugar.
Dot com.
Yes. And just push enter and just see what comes up there.
All right, enter.
You spelt it wrong.
Okay, just... It's a porn site.
Dave, you got a credit card?
No, why?
Because I need to subscribe.
Why are you messing with me?
Highveld, hello.
Hi, sorry. I'm finding a connection with this new competition.
Are you calling me on the work phone?
Yes.
Using the work phone for private business?
No.
94.7, I'm for stereo.
Hi, I was just finding you repeated a song.
So?
Didn't you?
Oh, which song?
No Air, by Jordan Sparks and someone else. You played it this morning on The Rude Awakening for the first time, and now you played it again.
Ma'am, if you opened your ears once in a while,
yeah,
you would know that it's from 9 to 5, only the repeats.
What, from 9 o'clock in the morning to 5 o'clock in the afternoon?
Yes. And now, what time? How many more times do we have to tell these damn people? What time is the Rude Awakening?
So don't be rude, okay?
No, answer me.
You're an idiot.
Hello and welcome. Thank you for calling the gay chat line. To proceed, please press 1.
He says thank you for calling the gay chat line. To proceed, press 1.
I'm sorry, I have not heard your selection. If you would like to go to the section, please press 1. Or alternatively, if you'd like to go to the oral section, please press 2.
Thank you for dialing the gay chat line. If you want oral, press 1 or 2.
94.7, hello.
Hi, you played the same song twice in one day. How does that work?
Okay, well, first of all, you need to take down this number.
Okay.
011.
Yeah.
396.
396.
2171.
2171.
That is the Broadcast Complaints Commission, and lay an official complaint there.
I don't want to lay a complaint. You guys have got a...
Or alternatively, you can lodge a complaint on hellopeter.com.
No, it's not
the
a
broadcast
complaint. You guys have got a thing running where you can win money if you phone in and tell... You're not supposed to be playing the same song twice in one day.
Oh, really?
Yeah. What's your competition line number?
This number here.
This number here, but well, then how can you not know about the competition?
Well, it's my first day.
But then can somebody else not help?
No, it's just me.
It's just you?
It's just me, yeah. Everyone's left without a fire drill.
You're kidding.
No.
Yeah. I got a fire suit, so...
You got a fire suit?
Yeah.
Oh.
So I'm alright. I've just got the window open a little bit. And I need a piss, so if it comes near me, I'm going to piss in it.
Lovely.
Yeah. Listen.
Yes.
What's that I can hear in the background there?
You've probably heard an ambulance in the road in the background, but if you
that
heard that,
the
you
fire.
Must have super hearing.
That is the fire truck coming to our building.
The fire truck coming to your building, right. We just phone back if we hear something else.
Hello?
Hi, is it 94.7?
No, it's not. What number are you looking for?
Isn't it 88947?
Yes, it is.
It's not Highveld, 94.7 radio station.
No, their number's changed.
Has it changed? Sorry for that.
Let me give you their number.
Yes, please.
10.
Yes.
26.
1026.
Yeah, no. That's their new studio number.
Okay, thank you very much, sir.
Just watch out, because their secretary likes giving you the time. So just tell her to shut up and tell her where you want to go. Bye-bye.
Highveld, hello.
Hello?
Hello?
I want to play that game, The Sound of Joburg. So what must I do?
You have to SMS, please, ma'am.
If I SMS, what must I do? Must I send my name? Must I send my...
When you SMS, you must just say, hi, Bubby.
Yeah.
Love your show.
Yeah.
Hope you well. Ma'am?
Yeah?
Can I bum a Lexington from you? Highveld, I might be of service.
Hi, how are you?
I'm very well.
What is your name?
My name's Piet.
Are you Afrikaans, Piet?
What do you for a living?
I work for a company called AfriPack.
And do they pack Africans?
Oh my God.
Hello?
Hi, listen, I'm phoning in regards to that competition, the 94.7 competition.
The cycle challenge, yes, the momentum cycle challenge. Do you have a bicycle?
No, I'm not actually phoning in for that competition.
Oh, you're phoning for the top 8 at 8. Okay, let me give you the number that you can call. Have you got a favorite song at the moment?
No, not that competition. What's the song competition?
You're phoning for the Sterkiniko competition.
No, that one where you
not
need to guess the song.
Are you phoning for the Bush Bash with Jeremy and Jackie Mansfield?
No.
The train departs 23 July.
No, that's just the song competition.
Why didn't you say so up front? Highveld, hello.
Hi, g'day.
Hi, good day.
I'm just phoning in for the competition.
I'm just phoning in for the competition.
Stop. Yeah.
Yeah.
Hello?
Hello?
Hello, hello.
Hello, hello.
You there?
You there?
Hello.
Hello.
Is this going to take long?
Highveld, hello.
Sorry, I'm speaking to?
To Pete.
Hello. Pete, what time is this competition that you guys have got? Do you know?
It's today sometime.
I'm sure it's today sometime, but don't you work there? Surely you know the answer, like time?
I'm on a need-to-know basis.
What does that even mean?
It means they only tell me what I need to know.
Are you for real?
I'm not allowed to know company secrets.
It's not a secret. They talk about it on the radio all the time.
Yeah, but that's programming. I'm reception.
Is there somebody else I could maybe speak to? Piet, please?
Okay, let me call my co.
Grant?
Hello?
Hello, ma'am. Who am I speaking to?
Margriet.
Hello, Margriet. How are you?
I'm fine. I'm Piet's sister.
Piet and Margriet.
I just phoned. I just wanted to find out about the time that I can call in for the Sound of Joburg. You know that competition that Highveld runs?
Yes, ma'am. I don't know what time.
Okay, that doesn't help me.
I'm going to need to know, baby.
What does that even mean? Piet told me the same thing. Is there not somebody else that I can please talk to?
Hello?
Hello?
Hello, this is Ravit, yeah?
Ravit. I'm actually starting to get a little bit annoyed now.
I'd like
to know what time the Sound of Joburg is coming on so that I can enter the competition.
Oh, okay. I understand you clearly now, ma'am.
Well, then, tell me a time.
I don't know.
You people are ridiculous. This is like how I felt stereo. Can't anybody there help me? This is so frustrating.
Highveld, hello.
I'm just phoning in to tell you that they're repeating a song again with Icon. I would like to love you.
Are you some kind of thick caller?
No, I'm not.
What did you just tell me?
You said that song from Icon.
You know, there are chat lines you can call. You said, I'd like to love you.
No, that's the name of the song. Icon, I like to love you.
You like to love me?
No, not you. It's the name of a song.
And what's it called?
It's called I Love You.
What, you freak? I don't love you. I don't even know.
Don't be stupid. It's the name of a song, you idiot.
But I don't even know you and you're telling me you love me. Take me out for dinner first.
Don't be stupid. I'm not a stupid idiot. I'm not gay as you think I am.
Well, then why are you telling...
It's the name of the bloody song, you idiot.
Have you ever even seen me and you're saying you love me? You're quite Eevee, eh, you freak?
I'm not a freak. Listen, yeah, I'm not bloody phoning to tell you about that I love you. I'm not flipping bloody gay. It's the name of a song.
Okay, and what's the name of the song?
I would like to love you.
Oh, I don't love you, you freak. How many times must I tell you?
Yeah, you people are so bloody stupid.
Well, you're desperate.
I didn't tell you I want to have sex with you, okay?
When you tell someone you love them, it's the easiest way to get in their pants.
Listen, yeah, just don't act stupid. I'm just going to put the phone down, because you're being bloody stupid now. You're a real d***.
There you go. Find the handle. Oh, no, you haven't put the phone down yet. Come on, keep going. You're almost there. Go on, turn it the other way around. Nope. You're still with me. You're still with me. Go, get it in the groove. Turn it around. Go. Ah, there you go.
Hello?
Huh?
Hi, is that Kenny?
Yeah, this is Kenny.
Kenny, you sound different.
Yeah, I sound different on the phone as to the radio. When I'm on the radio, I put on a bit of an American accent.
I just wanted to wish you for a belated happy birthday.
Oh, why didn't you call me yesterday, man?
Because, this is wrong.
This is Highveld. This is Kenny Maestri.
No, man, it's not Kenny. You're joking.
Yeah, you know what? I've put on the accent. I actually speak like a true Indian when I'm off a radio. But when I'm on a radio,
hi, this is Kenny Maestri.
I saw Kenny on the TV already on that other program, and I've seen heard him lots of times on the TV.
This is how I normally speak. But then when I'm on a radio, I'm,
hi, this is Kenny Maestri.
Come on, then talk like your normal. Otherwise, put on your accent and let me hear what you sound like with your accent.
Okay, hold on.
Hi, this is the Flavor to Savor of 94.7 FL Stereo on your dial.
Yes, that sounds like Kenny. You know, because I couldn't phone you yesterday. You were off yesterday. And also, like, when the program is on in the competition, then I hope you're going to be with us on our station for a very long time.
Thank you, ma'am.
All right, then.
Bye-bye. Welcome to 94.7 Highveld Stereo. For English, please press 1. For Afrikaans, please press 2. For Zulu, please press 3. I'm sorry, I have not heard your selection. For English, please press 1. For Afrikaans... So bono gunjani and welcome room to Farbaki 94.7 Highveld Stereo. Zimurko Hamaikaya is Kosasawena.
Hello. I've pressed one a few times.
I hear you speaking English. Is it English you would prefer? Please press one. So bono gunjani.
I don't know what's wrong with you people.
Do you have a problem with Zulu?
I have a problem with Zulu. Why can't I speak English?
Why are you being racist?
I know, I've...
Oh, no, you just can't.
I love Pete.
Oh. I felt hello.
Hi, my name's Teresa. I'm actually just trying to find out, for this party, for the Get the Laugh competition.
Yeah.
Well, how do you need to dress?
In a bikini, ma'am.
Oh, okay. Are you sure the bikini has to be a bikini?
Has to be a bikini.
Okay.
If it's not a bikini, you're not coming in.
Oh, my word.
Okay.
Okay, cool.
Okay, cool.
Thanks,
ciao.
Man.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. Oh,
Pinetown Post Office?
Is it 883-8947?
Yes, it is. It's the Pinetown Post Office.
No, I've got the wrong number. Sorry, sir.
Okay, bye-bye. How may I be of service?
Hi, good day. At 2 o'clock, there was a VIP club word given out. We couldn't hear it, and we found, because everything she said was loud, and then when the word came through, we couldn't hear what she said.
Yeah, you know what? We've been having a problem with Sarisha. She doesn't speak eloquently.
Okay, so there's 8 minutes left. How are we going to... We're 5 people here sitting dying to get the number or the name or the word, and there's no way we can get it.
The key word is supercalifragilisticexpialidocious, and you got to spell it 100% correct, okay.
Thank you so much.
Highveld, good afternoon.
Good afternoon. I just want to query the tickets for Celine Dion. I just wanted to know if you were able to help me with the amounts of the tickets.
It is 13,000 rand.
What do you mean, for one ticket?
For one ticket, yeah.
Is that the price for all the tickets?
No, that's for one ticket standing at the back.
At the back?
Standing. Looking through the window of the Coca-Cola Dome.
What is it?
Yeah. If you want a ticket, do you want a ticket inside?
Obviously.
35,000.
All right, who am I speaking to?
Pete.
All right, well, thank you so much for that.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye.
I felt alone.
Can you tell me, have you mentioned this keyword yet? But I just thought maybe I missed it because I'm working at the police. I'm on the switchboard.
Okay, I tell you what.
Who am I speaking to?
Pete.
Yes.
If I give you the key word,
yeah,
then can you squash a charge against me?
What is it?
Housebreaking.
Housebreaking, no, Darren. Thank you.
Okay, bye.
Yeah, bye.
Hi, Felt. Hello.
Hello.
Hello. How are you, big boy? Highveld, hello.
Hello.
Hi, how are you?
Fine, and you?
Good, what are you wearing?
Who's speaking?
It's Pete.
Sorry, I think it's the wrong number.
What number are you looking for? Highveld, hello.
Hi, afternoon.
Good afternoon, ma'am, how are you doing?
Well, I just tried my luck by phoning in and seeing if there's anything at all, competitions that you have.
Competitions?
I don't know, I'm just finding out.
Ma'am,
yes.
You are in luck.
Why?
You don't know what you've just done, do you?
No, not actually.
You've just won a Volvo.
Oh, you did, sir. I don't think I'm that lucky.
Well, that would be the right answer.
There's nothing happening now.
Nothing happening. We're not giving anything away, ma'am.
Oh.
Do you still do this no repeat? Because, I mean, I think they've just repeated one. This one is If Tomorrow Never Comes.
But it's not on right now. I've just turned on the radio.
Well, they've just finished it.
And it's some dance song.
Well, it's just finished. So, I mean, it was just playing just now.
But you
got... there's something else now.
Yeah, but you got no proof.
Hey?
You got no proof.
What?
That it played.
No, well, of course it's still playing now.
You should have phoned when it was playing.
Oh.
I feel hello.
Hello?
Hello, yes. I'm a bit of your service.
Yes, just find it. What time is the competition line open? Where you got to identify the song?
Oh, it's not now.
Yeah, no, clearly not, yeah.
Why did you call now if you knew it wasn't now?
No, I thought I'll just put you put me on hold.
For like 4 hours? That is bloody stupid.
What is stupid?
Because the cost of that call is going to be more than a bloody prize, you stupid fool.
Okay, I'll then, you know what, I'll phone back then, bye.
Hello?
Hello?
Speak or forever hold your peace.
Is this Highveld?
This is Rayma.
Rayma?
Can you please hold for a second? Oh, onward Christian soldiers marching as to war. Hi, welcome to Rayma. Have you been saved lately? Amazing grace, how sweet the sound. Hello, ma'am. Yes, thank you so much for holding. Do you want to speak to Ray?
Go ahead. Sorry, then.
Bless you, ma'am.
Thank you.
You're forgiven.
Thank you.
Okay. Yes. Bless your soul.
Can't be.
Half an hello.
Hello?
Hello. Are you going to be 94.7 for life?
No.
No.
I won't be in the country for life.
Where? England?
No, Germany.
Are you German?
Yes.
Are you? What's your surname?
Why?
Well, I want to see if you are actually German.
Excuse me?
Well, you don't sound German.
Yeah, well, good.
Well, what's your name?
Ursula.
That's an Afrikaans name. If you had a name like Good...
Never, ever, ever, ever is that an Afrikaans name. I've never come across any person in this country with my name.
Well, the only German names that I know is Gertrude and Beatrix.
Oh, okay. Well, Beatrice is not a German name.
Beatrix.
Beatrix?
Yes, I saw it in a porn movie.
Oh, my God.
What's your surname?
Yeah, well, you don't need to know.
Is it something like Schlossenberger?
No, definitely not.
Then what?
Okay, no, fine. I think this conversation's over now.
Gutenhausen?
Okay, no, fine. Goodbye.
Schmickel Schorkel?
Oh, you're terrible.
Hello?
Hello? Hello, am I too early for the competition?
Gotta give me details, lady. Are you one of these people that just calls and randomly wants a prize?
No, no, not me. This is the first time I've got through.
Cool, you sound very old.
I'm old enough to feel cold.
And that laugh is like a gin laugh.
You're too old to drink.
You sound like you were Miss Gilby's gin 1963.
No, definitely not.
Or maybe Mrs. Lexington 1971.
Oh. Could be.
Oh my greatness, you're the oldest person I've ever spoken to. You know they named a golf course after you.
Have they?
Yes. The Royal and Ancient St. Andrews.
Oh yes, yes, that could be.
By the way, Granny, you've been talking with Whackhead Simpson.
Oh, good Lord, am I?
Yes.
Oh, that's wonderful. How are you?
I'm fine. Can you be my gran?
Yes, why not?
Excellent. Hello?
Calling about a repeat of a song on the radio on Kelly Maestri's show by
Kelly.
Marley. There's supposed to be a prize.
Like what?
I'm not sure.
I've forgotten what the process is for this. I'm phoning the station manager.
Okay, good.
Yeah, well, what is your name?
Barry.
Okay.
Hi, this is Robbie. Sorry I can't get to the phone right now. Nobody there.
I'll phone the CEO.
Okay.
No. No.
Hello?
Terry?
Yeah?
Whackhead, listen, I've got Barry on the line.
Who's Barry?
I don't know.
I'm one of your listeners.
Barry says that we repeated the song. I don't know what the process is anymore if we do repeat the song. Do you perhaps know, Terry?
Well, I don't know what to do. Isn't there a number that he calls?
No, is there no cash to be won now?
Nah, the company's battling at the moment. Eh? When we started that competition, we were like rolling in it. And now, recession, times are hard. Dude, we've got no money left. Barry?
Yes?
I think you should stop listening to music and go listen to Talk 702. Go and see if Jenny Chris Williams repeats any words or phrases.
No, thank you.
And then phone and maybe you can win some cash.
Okay.
Thanks, dog.
All right, thanks, eh?
Thanks, Can't dog.
Hello.
Is this,
No, it's not. Who's asking?
It's Reginald.
How old are you, Reginald?
I am 18.
How do you get a name like Reginald and you're only 18?
What, does it sound like an old man's name?
Reginald is Latin for he who is born before 1932.
You're shocking.
You sound like you are Indian.
I sound like I'm Indian?
Yeah.
I get that a lot. I'm African.
You're a black dude.
I'm a black dude.
Dude, you sound like an Indian, dude.
I sound like an Indian.
With an old white man's name.
An Indian with an old white man's name.
That's my brother, nice. You are so confused in this new South Africa. I'll give you a nice African name.
Yes, please.
Absalon.
Absalon.
Second name, Lucky.
Absalon Lucky.
Bye-bye, Absalon.
thanks.
Highveld, what's your name?
Good afternoon.
It's not actually a good afternoon for me today.
You said it's not a good day for you. What's this got to do with the competition now?
Are you insensitive to my needs? I'm having a bad day.
Oh, stop.
Okay, sorry to hear about it.
Because I woke up this morning.
Yes?
My best friend Theo, he has become a dancer.
Okay.
And you know what that means?
Yeah.
What?
Become a dancer. So he's basically not a male anymore.
I think he's become a queer.
Queer.
Yes.
Is it? Now, why are you asking me about this now?
Because I've got no one else to talk to. I don't have a best friend anymore.
Ask him if he's gone queer or not.
Okay, hold on. I'm going to call him quickly.
But I don't know what's this got to do with the competition.
No, hold on. We'll get to that now. Just hold on. What's your name?
Scott.
Scott. Hold on, Scott. Okay, it's ringing. Hi, Theo. It's Bruce here. Listen, I've just been speaking to my friend Scott, and Scott says that you are queer because you become a dancer. Yes. So I don't want to be a friend no more. There you go, Scotty.
What number is this?
Do you want to be my best friend?
I don't think he does, you know.
Highveld, hello.
Good afternoon, how are you?
I'm fine, and you? Thanks for asking.
I'm just wanting to find out, how do I go about making a request?
And what would you like to say?
I would just like to say hi to my mom and them.
Just to say hi.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you know what I suggest?
Yes.
Are you on MTN or Vodacom?
Vodacom.
Okay, I suggest, Bianca, you go to your nearest garage shop and buy a 30 rand top-up voucher.
Yes.
And then you can phone your mom and say hi.
Okay.
That is the most direct route you can use.
All right.
Okay.
Thank you.
Bye. Highveld, hello.
Hello.
Hello, sir. How may I be of service, ma'am?
I want to get Jeremy's email address.
Let me spell it for you. It's P-O-R K-S-W O-R-D at Highveld dot co.za.
Highveld.co.za.
Oh, yes.
Man. Okay.
Highveld, hello.
I didn't get his email.
First of all, is there any way I can send out a dedication for someone's birthday today?
Oh, sorry, excuse me. Was that you or was that me?
No, this was probably you.
Sorry. I beg your forgiveness. Sorry. Highveld, hello.
Sorry, who's that?
This is Highveld. My name is Piet.
Piet, I think I've got the wrong number.
Sorry, sir. Can I just ask you a quick question? Do you go through more tissues watching the movie Ghost or ETV late on a Friday night?
Oh, my goodness.
Highveld. Hello?
Hello?
Got...
Okay, now you're breaking up.
And what?
Sorry, the line's breaking up. It's a very bad line. I can't hear a word that you say. I just hear
Get you go back.
Come on, man.
Get you go back. Can you please just stand up to get better signal?
All right. Can you hear me now?
Okay, now please just put your one hand in the air. It normally works like an aerial.
You're kidding me, alright?
Okay, talk.
Alright, can you hear me now?
Yes, how can I help you?
No, I would just like to dedicate a song.
And who would you like to dedicate it to?
To my boyfriend.
Okay, what song would you like?
Dilemma.
By Nelly and Kelly. And what is the message?
I just want to say thank you for the last couple of months.
that he's big by me, and yeah, that I love him very much.
What has he done in the last couple of months?
He just like supported me in everything.
And what were you doing that he was supporting you in?
I don't know. I've been through a lot.
Did you cheat on him?
No.
Did you badmouth his mother?
No.
Did you flirt with his father?
No.
Did you spend his money?
No.
Have you been pressurizing him to get married?
No. So my arms are getting really tired.
Have you been spontaneously breaking out into tears?
No.
Are you high maintenance?
No, I'm not.
So what was all the support about?
I don't know, he's been there for me. Every time that I needed someone. How many questions still to go?
How old are you?
20.
Okay, what's his name?
Humphrey.
Humphrey. How old? How can you date an old guy called Humphrey? Humphrey is an old Latin name, meaning born before 1947.
Humphrey.
I'll only be able to make this dedication tomorrow morning on the Rude Awakening.
All right.
At 7:10.
7:10?
In the morning, yes.
Oh, my gosh.
I think you've got your hand down now.
I'm pulling my heart out here to Whackhead Simpson. You've been trying to tell me I've been phoning the whole day just to get pranked.
It's one thing when you phone somebody to prank them. Yeah. It's another thing when somebody phones you to get pranked.
Yeah.
That's the Cash Hotline. Hello.
Good day. How are you, sir?
I'm cool on you.
I just wanted to find out what's the album of this song is playing now.
Just give me one second, dude.
Okay, sir.
Is it this that's playing now on the radio?
Yeah, the one that's playing now.
Okay, you want to know the artist or the album?
The artist and the album, yes. One of the old school songs.
You want to go to the shop to try find it?
That's yeah, what... bro.
You got a pen and paper?
Yes, I have one.
Okay, G-R...
G-R...
Double O...
Double O...
T...
T...
S-T-E...
S-T-E...
Treffers...
T-R-E...
F-F-E-R-S...
S-S-E-R-S...
And the artist?
Yes.
Steve?
Steve, yes.
Hoffmeyer.
Hoffmeyer.
No.
Okay, thank you very much. I love you.
Thanks, buddy. Bye-bye. Highveld, hello.
What competition do you have on now?
The competition right now is win a donkey.
Okay. Okay, so please tell me how exactly it's working.
To win the donkey, you've got to come to the studio and pin the tail.
Where is the studio exactly?
The studio is in Alexandra.
Okay.
You know the township?
Okay.
Highveld, how may I be of service?
I've got the wrong number, sorry.
What were you looking for? Jacaranda?
Yes.
Let me give you their number quick. It's 0860-Kakaranda.
Thank you.
And I'm not surprised their number's the same as ours because they copy everything else we do. Highveld, hello.
Hi, good morning. Where can we fax a fundraising letter to? We need to raise funds. Who can assist us there on your side?
What is your organization?
So we are a government school.
Okay, I'll tell you where you can. Let me give you an email address where you can fax it to.
All right.
Okay, it's DE, Department of...
Yeah?
Education.gov.za.
Now, I was hoping that Highveld could maybe help with some donation.
Okay, how much do you need?
It depends on how much you can offer. Any amount is welcome.
Okay, well, ma'am, right now I've got R1.80.
No.
Can you come fetch it? Highveld, hello.
Most 10 or 12 names. Can you perhaps tell me which names are called out?
Okay. Felicia Mabuza Sattel.
Yes.
Eugene Terblanche.
Yes.
F.W. de Klerk.
Thanks, Dave.
Nelson Mandela. And Freek Robinson.
Yeah. Eugene Terblanche and all the politicians.
Well, my man, Eugene wants a Volvo instead of that horse. He's looking for a bit more horsepower.
That's very, very nice.
Highveld, hello.
Can I have a request, please?
What would you like?
Well, I'd like When You Gone by Avril Lavigne for my girlfriend.
And what message?
Just tell her that I'm sorry about the fight we had last night.
Oh, Nicola. Oh, were you guys boxing?
Yeah, duck fight, eh?
Okay, well, why don't I phone her for you?
You can do that.
Hello?
Hi, Nikki.
Hi.
What you doing?
Nothing much.
I heard that you and Ronnie are having a few problems.
Who is this?
It's Piet the counselor.
Okay.
Now, I believe he was a bit magoo last night.
Yeah?
And he phoned me and he's like very sorry.
He's very sorry? I'm so sorry. I actually am like really taken aback. I don't know who, I don't even know of you. I don't know.
Okay, do you know of a guy called Whackhead Simpson?
What?
I have Ronnie here with me. Ronnie, talk up, brother.
Hey, babe.
Oh, my God! Ronnie!
Yeah?
And this?
I phoned Darren Larson to phone you, so I'll tell you how sorry I am.
Oh, babe.
No, babe.
I love you.
Oh, no, that's so sweet.
You're making me cry.
No, don't cry, please.
You're making me cry, too.
You know
do
what?
We call it a truce?
Yeah, we can call it a truce.
Okay, no, just give each other a kiss on the phone.
I love you, babe.
I love you too,
babe. You see, you know what? You have screwed yourself so badly now.
Why?
Because every oak who has a disagreement with his girlfriend is now going to go, okay, you know what I'll do? I'll phone Whackhead. I'll get Whackhead to find my chick and everything will get
better. Everything.
You know what? You
screwed yourself.
Highveld, hello?
Hi, I'm trying to find out whether you've got a line or if you're taking any reports on the FIFA ticket sales at all.
What would you like to say, ma'am?
Just in terms of the complete chaos that exists at the First National Bank branches, it's a disaster, an absolute disaster.
Okay. What tickets were you looking for specifically?
Well, any category tickets. We just couldn't. They never sold, other than the 4 tickets in the 3 hours that I was there.
Okay, well, I might help you here. I've got some tickets here by Highveld. Would you be interested in purchasing?
Well, what tickets have you got?
Estonia versus Mongolia. They're yours for $600.
No.
Ma'am, at least you can say, I was there.
I'll skip on that. Don't worry. I don't need tickets for that.
Ooh. Wow.
Highveld, how may I be of service today?
I'm speaking to...
A bit. What's your name?
Charles.
So, Chuck, what can I do for you?
Yeah, man. I need to ask you about the competition for Jeff's Daily Diary.
Jeff, yeah, you know, that's personal. Nobody goes into anybody's diary these days, eh? That's not right. Would you like somebody going through your diary?
No.
No, it's not nice, hey. Do you have children?
Yeah, 2.
Yes, don't go into their room looking for their diaries to find out what they're doing. It's not right, Chuck. I don't know how you were brought up, but it's wrong. And
oh, man.
Yes, is there anything else I can help you with, Chuck?
No, this is about the BP challenge competition.
Yes, would you like the BP bank statements too?
No.
Would you like to know what the MD earns?
No, man, I need to get into the competition.
Chuck, it's wrong, that's all I'm saying.
Uh-huh.
I never thought I would talk to somebody that was so nosy before.
No, man. That's why I'm calling you, maybe to find out maybe where Jeff is.
Now, you see, now you want me to cheat and tell you where he is. Chuck, you have got no morals whatsoever.
Oh, okay.
I don't know which side of the tracks you grew up on, but look, the train to Krugersdorp has already left.
Mm.
Chuck, I think you better go to church.
To church?
Yes.
I've been to church yesterday night.
Well, Chuck, I suggest you go back today because you didn't learn anything there yesterday.
Yeah. No. I'm just...
Hello, Highveld. What's your problem?
What number is that?
This is 88...
Yes?
38...
Uh-huh. 946. I dialed 947, and it's showing that I dialed 947.
Could be a crossed line. It's not the first time we've gotten calls. Is this for Highveld?
Highveld, yes.
Highveld.
Highveld.
Sorry, Highveld.
No, Highveld.
Yes, yeah. We, it's as I say. It's not the first time we've received calls for Highveld.
Okay, sorry.
Yes, sometimes you know people. The number instead of them pushing 7, they clap a 6.
for my speaking. Thank you so much for making me laugh today. I'm sorry I dialed the wrong number.
Okay, now just test now and just push 7 on your phone.
Right now, while I'm speaking to you.
Yes, push 7.
What's the...
That was a 7, yes. Push it again. I just don't want you to push 6 because I don't want to talk to you again, okay, love? Just test that the 7 is working, because if the 7 doesn't work, then go push the 4 and the 3, okay? So you'll go 8-8-3-8-9-4-4-3=7.
You are a terrible creature.
Okay.
Or you could push 5-2. It doesn't matter.
I don't thought it up to 7. Or even 6-1.
6-1 is also fine. There we go.
Okay.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Okay, bye. Hello.
Oh, no. Not again.
You're pushing a bloody 6 again.
I pushed a 7.
You pushed a 6 because that means you come for me. Okay.
I'll try again.
Okay. Think and concentrate, woman. Okay.
Bye.
Bye.
Hi.
Hello?
Hi. So tell me, is this Dr. Pierre's offices?
This is Dr. Pierre's offices, yes.
Is it? And so can I please speak to Mr. Pierre or Dr. Pierre?
Yes, doctor has been expecting your call. Just hold on.
Dr. Pierre? Yes, got late. Okay.
Hi, ma'am?
Yes.
Doctor says that your results are back, and yes, you do have athlete's foot.
Excuse me?
Doctor just confirmed that you've got athlete's foot, ma'am.
Actually, I spoke to him yesterday.
Yes.
And he asked me to give him a call back regarding the purchasing of printer and fax machine cartridges.
Ma'am, I've got to go. You are filthy. Harfield, may I be of service?
Hello, hold on for me.
You've got to be joking. Nobody puts Pete on hold.
Hi, it's the
Highveld. Hello, yes. Sorry, can you hold on for me now, please?
Okay. Hello? Hi, can you hear me? Hello? Can you hear me?
Hello, Highveld. How can I tend to your needs?
I've been entering the VIP earn words.
Yes.
I did one with Alex Gay this morning at 11:04, and one with Mark Pilgrim last evening at about 5:30. And normally I get a response straight away. I send my word through and get the response straight away, and I've not received it for either one of those. I've sent it twice each time. What must I do?
Okay. What was the word you needed to send firstly?
The word today was good.
Good.
Yeah. And the other one last night, step, I think.
Step?
That one last night and the other one this morning.
How good is your spelling?
My spelling is excellent.
Okay, how did you spell good?
G-O-O-D.
You see, problem.
What?
It's G-U-D, good.
No. Yes. No, 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 no.
Yes, good. G-A-D.
Okay, and then step, I suppose, is what?
How did you spell it?
S-T-E-P?
No, it's S-T-E-P-P, step.
Then when I make a mistake, like send the wrong word because I didn't hear it properly, I send it through and I get a message straight away saying...
Stupid. Yeah, where did you go to school, ma'am?
Maybe too long ago.
Yes, ma'am, lots of things have changed since then, like the road names, the fashions, and also the spellings.
Yes. Hello, throbbing eel.
Hi, good evening.
Hello.
Hello. Yes, can you hear me?
Yes, this is a throbbing eel.
Throbbing eel?
Yes.
Very naughty.
Is that the name of the place?
Yes.
Sorry, ma'am. I was looking quite exterior. Sorry, ma'am.
Okay.
Thank you.
Ciao. Bye bye. Hello?
Hello, where am I?
One eyed wonder muscle, hello.
Number.
What number are you looking for?
Highveld.
Okay, this is the one-eyed wonder muscle.
Sorry, sir.
Okay.
Thank you.
Bye. Hello? Hello, how may I help you? This is the custard chucker.
The what?
It's the custard chucker company.
Jeez, you were bored.
Yes. What were you looking for?
For Highveld Studio.
Wrong number. Yes, push the red knob on your phone.
Stop it.
The red knob.
How bored were you yesterday?
Man,
I'm
alive.
Always bored. Hello.
What number is that?
What number you look for?
8838947.
It's wrong.
Sorry?
The madam is not here.
The madam is not there?
No.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, bye. Okay. Let's see what happens when I connect listeners with other listeners on the phone. Hello?
Hi, I'm just phoning in the hope I'm going to get through.
Hello?
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 Hi, where am I through to?
It's Juan. I'm phoning for a sound that's over.
Oh, sorry, wrong number.
Okay, bye.
Hello?
Hi, who am I speaking to? Hello? Hi, can I help you? Where am I now? Alec Levin Associates. Sorry, wrong number.
Hello?
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 Hi, can I help
you? Is this Highveld? The sound of Joburg?
Yes.
Can I...
No, I think our lines are crossed, but I'm phoning in as well.
Is it?
For what
yes.
are you guys phoning in?
Oh, okay.
Pardon?
Okay.
But what are you guys phoning in?
Hello, what number is that?
Hi, sorry, the sound of Joburg competition
club. Yes, I would like to enter the competition, please.
You would like to enter the competition,
yes.
I think, but I'm trying as well.
How may I be of your service?
Hi, yes, tell me, I wanted to make a dedication.
Really? Who would you like to make it out to?
To my boyfriend, Piet.
Would you like a song?
Yes, I would.
What would you like?
That's Beautiful in Beaufort West.
Sung by?
Tian Shodan.
Okay, I'm just going to dial the studio and see if we can hook you up.
RSC, goeiemiddag.
Kan jy asseblief net een klein bekkie vinnig met Claudia praat?
Okay.
Praat met die vrou?
Hallo.
Hallo.
Hi, yes, tell me how that's if you could put play Tian Shodan for me in Beautiful in Beaufort West.
No, we don't do requests.
Yeah,
and
well,
then they put it on a playlist, which is on a Tuesday already.
Okay, ma'am, let me be honest. It's Whackhead Simpson from 94.7, all right?
Yes.
And Claudia phoned in to me asking me to play Tien Shou Dime, but we already played him this morning, so we can't play it again. So I was hoping Addis Clear could help us out.
No, we can't.
Oh, come on.
Margaret.
Whackhead Simpson.
Highveld, hello.
Am I now at Highveld?
Yes, correct.
I was just calling into Anneli's show about the movie moment, like what happened to me.
Yes, what was your movie?
It was that I came home one day and then the guy I was living with had moved out and taken everything with him. And then, yeah, that was it. I came home and all the furniture was gone, and so was he. I was left at the house.
Oh, shame.
Hello.
Hello, it's Mrs. Khan speaking.
Yes, how may I serve you today?
I am trying for the competition, my dear.
Can you tell me a story?
Like what kind of story?
Any story. Tell it nice.
Like
Chuck and Jill or something.
Once upon a time.
I'm gripped. What happens? What happens to them?
They died.
You tell the worst bloody stories in the world.
Yeah.
Highveld, hello?
Good morning. I'm sorry to worry you.
Worrying me, yes.
Sorry. I'd just like to know, please, yesterday on Alex J's show, he gave out a question about crocodile dung. Now, unfortunately, I couldn't get the answer.
As management, we have spoken to him about it already.
What about it?
That level of content is not allowed on this radio station anymore.
Are you going to complain?
Would you like to lay this complaint?
I just want to know what the answer was.
Have you heard of Hello Peter, ma'am? I suggest you leave a complaint there as well.
Why?
About talking about dung on the wireless.
That's being silly. It was a genuine question.
It's not acceptable, ma'am. So
I don't want to lay a complaint at all. I thoroughly enjoyed the show.
I would suggest it goes straight to the top. Terry Falkvein is the CEO here.
I'd just like to know the answer. I unfortunately missed it.
What was the question?
What was crocodile dung used for a long time ago?
Contraception. They used to put it on, and the odor would push the person away. The person would not go near that person purely because... And it later went on to cow dung, ma'am. Hey. Highfield, what's your problem?
Hi, is the Father's Day competition done?
Are you a father?
I am of two, hey?
Nice. What are their names?
Their names is Joshua and Christopher.
And which one did you have more fun making?
What kind of a question is that?
It's a normal question.
No, but you can't ask me that.
Why not?
No, hell no, I'm not going to answer that. I'm offended by the question you're asking me.
Well, just because you're offended doesn't mean that you're right.
No, you can't ask me that. Like, what the hell? Who am I speaking to?
To Piet.
To Piet. Piet, who's Piet? Piet, what's your surname?
It's Piet Kardashian.
Is the father's competition that? Just say yes or no.
Maybe.
Well, what do you know, Piet?
I know how to spell my name.
Oh!
Piet, like...
Why are you so secretive?
Dude, like, really, you're, like, working on my last nerve here, and, like, I'm very f***ed off right now. You should be doing filing or something. You shouldn't be answering phones. Because you're giving a bad impression to the company, to Highveld.
Okay, let's do a take two, then. 94.7, Highveld, hello, can I help you?
Hi, good day. I am calling in for the Father's Day competition.
Okay, and which child did you enjoy making more?
Oh, my word. Bye, bye.
Love you.
Bye, Piet.
Love you.
No, I'm not interested, dude.
Jeez, you're a frigid b***h.
Wow.
That is just rude.
Love you.
Bye.
Love you.
Love you.
702, hi.
Hi, I'm phoning about the small business issue.
Yes, what would you like to say, ma'am?
We basically, I work for a non-profit that supports small businessmen in the townships around town. We just got tired of waiting for this new department to do stuff. We got tired of waiting for the government to do stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I just thought that perhaps it would be an interesting comment to make.
No, that's boring.
Wow.
It's boring. Do you want me to liven it up a bit?
Yes, can you try, please?
Well, it's along the lines of everyone seems to sit down and complain about the government not doing anything. But the fact is, that's what's got us to where we are now. People actually start needing to do things for themselves.
Yeah, still boring. Still boring.
Okay.
Can you add something extra to the story? Like, say maybe 6 people died while you were doing this. When you go on the radio, okay, what are you going to say?
No, I'm not going to say that.
Just say that these skilled business people, the 6 of them die every day.
Right, okay, but I mean I can't because it's not true. So
no, it doesn't have to be true.
Oh!
Who am I speaking to?
Speaking to Piet.
But I mean, they aren't. I'm a bit confused by why you're trying to ask me to say that 6 of our guys die. We only have 17, so it would be quite quick before they all died out.
Yes, so that means you've got 3 days before your company's gone. So there's an urgency attached to this.
Right. I can't. I mean, I obviously can't. This is very funny.
No, your company, your people are dying in your company.
But they're not.
No, but for the purposes of good radio, say they are.
No, I can't, because we were sort of...
Hello, 702 Cape Talks.
Hi, how's it? I'd love to speak to you really quickly. I'm a first-time caller.
Is this about the bad breath?
Yeah, I've got some amazing advice for everyone suffering from it.
Is it your... could you talk away from the phone a bit, please?
Sorry, there we go. Is that better?
Ooh, yeah, no, because I can actually... Your phone, you've got bad breath, right? Because
I actually don't. But
no, you do. No, you do. No, listen to me. You do. I can smell it from here.
This is actually quite serious. So if there's a slot in, I definitely chat to you already. But if not, I will on the radio.
Okay, hold on. I'm just covering my mouth and nose here while I'm talking to you. What did you have for breakfast?
I actually don't eat breakfast in the morning.
Did you? Because it smells like you had a turd sandwich for breakfast.
That's coming through very clear on that side.
Yeah. Keep your mouth closed and talk through your nose, please. Okay, what is your advice?
I would like to raise the topic of tonsillolith with Reedy.
Tonsillolith.
Tonsillolith.
Is it tonsillolith? How do you say it?
Tonsillolith.
Is that it? Is that right?
That's it.
Tonsillolosis.
A couple fewer lows, but tonsillolosis is what it is, yeah.
Solosis.
That's it, yeah.
Is that it?
That's it.
Got it. Okay, what do you want to talk about?
I would like to... chat about
tonsillolosis. That's it. What is your name? It's Piet.
You're actually really starting to frustrate me here.
Yes.
Either I'm going to speak to Reedy or I'm going to hang up right now.
Okay, I just need to know what I need to tell Reedy. That it's what? It's
tonsillolosis.
Did you just call me a tonsil?
I just want to let you know that I'm actually recording this call.
Yes.
So either you're going to help me out here and let me help other people, or I'm going to hang up right away.
It's
you're actually starting to irritate me.
It's tonsillolosis. Is that right?
Tonsillolosis.
How do you spell that?
Tonsil, T-O-N-I... T-O-N-S-I-L,
Why didn't you just say so, tonsillolis?
I've been saying all along. Clearly we're not getting anywhere here, are we? I would like to speak to Reedy. If it's not possible, I'm going to hang up, all right?
If you want to talk to her, you can call her on her cell phone talk after 12, because she's busy now. She's busy with a show, a radio show.
Exactly, and that is why
I'm
going
in. She's working. People don't... Do people call you while you're working?
How often do I speak to her?
Call her on her cell phone after 12 o'clock when she finished.
I'm wanting to speak live on the radio.
On the radio.
There, maybe that's Reedy.
That's not Reedy, that's my other phone.
Maybe Reedy's calling you.
Hello? Well, thanks to yourself.
Hello?
Hello?
Hi.
Hi, how are you?
Fine, and you?
I'm well, thank you.
Good.
I'm signing in to win tickets for the 1D.
Are you looking for the D?
I beg your pardon?
You want the D?
No, I want tickets.
You want 1D.
I've got one D.
Oh, man.
I can give you the D.
Right, well, so what am I going to do to in the One Direction ticket?
If you want the D, you're going to have to sweet talk me a little bit. And then maybe serenade me and you might get the D.
Must I serenade you? How do I do that?
Sing.
Must I sing for you? It's like a love song.
Yes. And then I might just give you the D.
I'm sorry? I want to lay you down on a bed of roses.
No, more.
No, more what? More of the song?
I'm not that easy.
That was the first song that popped into my head.
Well, if you sit on my lap, we can talk about the first thing that pops up.
Oh, no, thank you.
You phoned for the D.
I phoned for the One Direction ticket.
Oh, I thought you wanted the D.
No, I don't want that D. I want the other D, the One Direction ticket.
Oh, no, I don't have any, man. Sorry.
But I phone in every day and I'm always too early and then they tell me to phone back. And the other guy took my number yesterday, but I never got a call back.
Shame.
Okay, should I rather just phone back?
Can I tell you when to phone back?
Yes.
Never.
Okay. Okay, I'll phone back. Thank you very much.
Okay, bye.
Bye.
Such a
Highveld, hello?
Hello?
Hello, this is Highveld.
Hi.
Hi, can I help you?
I was calling for the One Direction tickets.
Okay, can I transfer you, please?
Yes.
You're in the wrong department, okay?
Okay.
You're in the library at the moment. I'll transfer you to the competition department. Please hold.
Okay.
Hello.
Hi.
Can I help you, please, ma'am?
I'm calling for One Direction tickets.
Oh, you want to be in the competition department?
Yes, please.
Okay, no, I must transfer. They put you through to the toilet. They put you through to the toilet. I'll transfer you to competitions. At 947. They put you through to the toilet at 947. Hold on, ma'am. Hold on. Hey, good day.
Hi.
How can I help you now?
I'm calling for the One Direction tickets.
Oh, why did they put you through here? You need to go to the competition department.
Okay.
Yeah, they've put you through to the kitchen.
No, I want to speak to someone in charge with the One Direction ticket.
Yeah, they put you through
it's
to
for my little niece.
Okay, yeah, they put you through to the kitchen. I must transfer you to the competition department. Okay, hold on. Hold on. Hello?
Hello?
Hello? Can I help you, please? Thanks.
I'm calling for the One Direction tickets, my kid.
They put you through to the wrong departments. That's the competitions department.
Okay.
Yeah, they put you through to the garage.
Really?
Yes. Okay, I'll transfer you now, ma'am.